Greetings and welcome to CAS 892-730, Writing Successful Grants. If that's not the class that you signed up for, you're in the wrong place. This is an intensive roughly two-week class. It starts June 1 and ends June 12th. It's a one-credit class, and let me give you a bit of an overview of what it is that we're going to try to accomplish with this class. I'll do a bit of in-depth work on the syllabus so that you know what my expectations are. But I did want to start out by just telling you a little bit about my background in grant writing. I suspect over the years, if we totaled them all up, I've been responsible or partly responsible for bringing in literally millions of dollars to Michigan State University and tens of thousands of dollars to other organizations in the community. And I've also landed a few grants for myself along the way. I kind of got started in this field in 1986 when I came to the School of Criminal Justice over at I'm being joined by my little dog Lemmy, who will undoubtedly interrupt a number of these videos, so if you see me scrabbling around, I'm either going for water or I'm taking care of little Lemmy. But I was just launching into telling you a bit about my background. I wrote a number of grants that were primarily project or program-based grants. That was what I did at first. I have since done arts grants, personal grants in order for me to be able to do creative things. I've been involved in some research grant proposals. I've produced money for Michigan State University, also done grant proposals for nonprofit organizations in the community. So I have a fairly extensive background and a fairly decent track record in being able to land some good grants, so I'm hoping that that'll help in giving you some information that you need to become successful in the grant world. The purpose of the course is to give you an overview of the entire constellation of grants that there are out there, and there are a variety of different places and different kinds of grants, primarily divided between government public grants and foundation grants. But in reality, I mean, there are grants for research, there are grants for programs and projects and arts grants and community grants and all different kinds of grants, and they all have their unique sorts of flavor. So in addition to hearing from me, you're going to be hearing from some experts in the field and people who are program officers and people who have some information that you need to have to become successful. So what I'm trying to do with this class is, in addition to giving you that broad overview, is also help you build the skills that you'll need in order to be successful as a grant writer. I don't know whether your future is to be the researcher who will be doing your own grants and you'll be the PI, or maybe you'll be assisting other people in bringing in money, or you might go to work for a nonprofit in the community or decide at some point that you're going to become Pablo Picasso and you need to be able to get that iPad nowadays so you can do a good job with your artwork. Whatever the goals are, I'm hoping to be able to give you enough skills to be able to be competitive out there in the grant world. You can't always guarantee success because it's a highly competitive field. Different studies will tell you that as little as 8% of the grant proposals that are written are ever funded. That's not terribly encouraging. But the overview for what the class requires is that basically your grade is divided into two sections. The first half is that you will have to watch a series of videos, and you will have to give me a brief paragraph on your three main takeaways from each. And those are going to be videos in addition to the one from me that you're going to be hearing soon. I have two videos with Dr. Maria Lipinski from the College of Communication Arts and Sciences here at Michigan State, who gives a wonderful overview and lots of tips on what you need to know. You'll also watch a video from John Harrison at the MSU Library. There are free resources there at the library that you simply cannot access outside that system, and they're invaluable. We have not quite reached the point yet where we have what I would call the grant-o-matic. You know, you put in a few particulars and it tells you, okay, here's the foundation that will give you $1 million. But we're getting close. Another two videos from Dr. Rick Wash, again in my college, in the School of Journalism, on how to be successful with NSF-NIH grants, which are a main source of funding for many of the units here on campus. Then there's an interview with Robbie DiPietro, who's a program officer at the Michigan Humanities Council. Humanities grants are an excellent way to fund things you may want to do. And then I talked with, on video, Debbie Mikula and Josh Holliday at the Arts Council of Greater Lansing about arts grants and how different they are. So you will watch those videos, react to them, and post your analysis of what you think the main points were that you want to remember. And then there are also 5 readings that I'm going to ask you to take a look at, and also do takeaways from those different written online resources. The whole point of that is to sort of give you a broad range of views and perspective and advice from people who are really at the cutting edge of all of these grant opportunities. So that's half your grade. The other half of your grade is made up on you get a mix and match, a series of real world exercises. If you're working on a grant and you need to spend time on part of a proposal, this is a great time to do that and get credit for it and get some feedback on ideas that may help you make that portion of the grant more successful. If you're not working on a particular grant proposal at the time, we have some other real-world type exercises that are very common. And you have to pick and mix and match. There are different weights and values from 25 points to 50 points to 75 points. So you have to figure out a way to get 100 points of material uploaded. That'll take care of the full grade, and then there's one extra credit opportunity, which is a short quiz on glossary terms, the grant glossary. Some popular, or maybe not so popular, but some of the jargon. You need to know the jargon to be successful in the grant world. If you don't know what a fiduciary, agent is, then you can't write and try to find one when you need one. And there are terms like that that are really important. So we will be having a list of terms that are available. The entire course is done on Desire to Learn, D2L. All of our correspondence should take place within that format. Don't email me outside the system, because the beauty of D2L is that all of our correspondence will be together all in one place. Your email's mine. I also invite you to give me a call, because I'm here in the community, happy to talk, even be willing to get together for coffee someplace at a nice coffee shop and give you some firsthand feedback. My telephone number is 517-349-4752. Basically, all the information that you need to succeed in the class is in the syllabus. So I'll tune out for now, and then you'll see me again in that overview lecture and tips and ideas that I'll be giving you. Thank you.